true pimp, spin no dough on the booty. Yell, there go Mace, there go your cutie.
Having to pay interest on credit cards, and it means being financially secure.
Well, I guess the definition of good credit depends on the context. If you're talking about credit rating in general, it's having a score that is high enough that lenders would be willing to extend you credit. If you're talking about good credit in a more general sense, I think it's having a state of affairs such that when applying for a loan, you would be likely to be approved. When seeking financial aid in other respects, you would likely be approved. And generally, if you're talking about in a reputational sense, it would be not having any kind of debts outstanding or financial obligations unmet such that your neighbors and friends think that you're a deadbeat.
Having a good credit refers to having a good credit score, which means you have reputable dealings with credit cards and accounts, personal accounts.
It's a couple different things. One, it's developing and opening up a line of credit with like different credit companies with credit cards like Visa, and that you're not being late on your payments, and that establishes good credit. That allows you to then make
good credit. Is, I guess it's good for some people like me when I'm applying for a house and get loans or stuff like that. But for me personally, I don't think having credit at all should be like a necessity, because if you have money, you can pay for it yourself. So credit isn't like on the top of my list personally, but for those who think they can't live without it, I guess it's
cool. Having good credit means that I can borrow money for things maybe I can't afford now, like a house or a car at a lower interest rate, which in the long run saves me and my family.
Good credit to me, Matt, especially when I was buying my first home. You can usually buy a car, other things like that, get credit for it, but when you buy your first home, that good credit is really important. They look at that credit score, and you have to know, well, if you don't have it, you can't buy a house. So it was really important to me to always be checking on that before I bought my first home.
How do you go from having bad credit to good credit?
Well, there's a couple different ways you can do that. First thing you should probably do is, and I don't know if you can use a couple of different services. I don't know how good freecreditreport.com is, but there's different services like that now. It charges you. If you have a severe problem, you have to pay money to get rid of it. And one of the ways is to actually, if you wanted to do it by yourself, you go pull your credit report. Pull your credit report and see who you have paid late and who you're delinquent with. First off, you have to cure all the delinquency. Go out there, see what's past due, and go pay it. Second off, you call your lenders and you say, you know, this has been on here. Now, keep in mind, if it's a recent delinquency, they won't pull it. Like, it needs to be at least 2 years, maybe a year and a half of good payments on all your credits for them to consider taking that derogatory. That's what we call it, is a derogatory. For they need to have something to consider taking that derogatory off. So one, you cure your you pull your credit report. Two, you cure all your delinquencies. 3, you pay on all your credit that you have, pay well for a little bit. And then 4, contact your lenders and say, hey, can I get that removed? You write them letters and you say, you know, I'm trying to do XXX, and you know, you've got a past 90 on here. You know, you're paid, you're in full, can you remove that from my...
Miss Hargis' card is missing. Thousands of dollars have been charged to her credit cards, her checking account is empty, and loans she never took out appear on her credit report. What happened? She's been a victim of identity theft, an increasingly common and inventive crime. Identity theft occurs when somebody uses your personal information to commit fraud or other crimes. It may also involve computer fraud, mail fraud, wire fraud, and financial institution fraud. Some personal information thieves might be looking for are your name, your address and telephone number, your social security number, your driver's license, birth date, credit card numbers. This might seem like a lot of information to protect,